For this video, it was very simple. I created a story based on a cutscene from Zelda Majora's Mask. If you don't remember, during one of Link's memory, we see Princess Zelda. The scene takes place after the event of Zelda Ocarina of Time. And after watching this, I thought that it would be cool to put images on those words. And that's how I created the story. Building the environment for this video was a really cool experience. I was inspired a lot by Ghibli films and their incredible backgrounds. There is always a lot of color, nature, and beautiful views on sky and clouds. It creates this huge feeling of freedom and exploration. And that's some of the ingredients that I wanted to recreate for my environment. So what you see here is like a new recreation of Ocarina of Time, but with my own vision. You can even see some details here in the background, like Hyrule Castle Town and Death Mountain. Pretty cool, right? As you saw at the end of this animation, we see the hero shooting at Hyrule Castle. And I wanted to talk about the mystery of his curse. I know that there is a lot of theories about it, but I wanted to add my own touch to it. Now, I know that some of you won't like what I'm about to say, because my answer to Link's curse might be much easier than you imagined. I think Link's curse was made by Ganondorf at the end of Zelda Ocarina of Time. Remember what he said the moment he is banished into the void of the Evil Realm by the sages? He actually put a curse on Zelda and Link. You might say, no, it was something he said like that because he had too much hatred. But what if this was the real explanation to that curse? If we analyze this a little bit more deeper, the result of Zelda's curse is that she made the mistake to send Link back in time. Because of this, in her timeline, she was left without a hero. And when Ganon returned, the kingdom had no choice than put the fate of Hyrule in the hand of the goddesses. And their only option was to flood the kingdom. This is the story of Zelda Wind Waker. Link, on the other hand, lost everything, and no one remembers what he did. A hero shade is an adult, which means that the child he was in Majora's Mask had grown up at some point. After Majora's Mask, the Happy Mask salesman tells Link that he should go back home. Link probably did a few steps back and came back to Hyrule, where he had a new adventure. He became a man, but his life was cursed already. And eventually, with time, he ended up becoming the Hero Shade. I even think that his last adventure as an adult had something related to the Twilight Realm. But that's another theory. For this video, I was inspired by a lot of theories in the game concerning the Zonai. Most of us imagine the Zonai as friendly people, but what if this wasn't the case? Imagine if they are Ganon's followers. If you look at their armor in Breath of the Wild, it shares similarities with Ganon's design, right? This question inspired me for this video, as well as the possibility to have Zelda playable during dungeons. The environment for this one was really fun, because I wanted to create something that looks like an old temple with Zonai structures everywhere. I followed the same idea of the trailer when we see Link and Zelda exploring something underground. This isn't a big location, so I was able to add a lot of details here and there, like all the particles and the smoke effect. I also took the liberty to add the symbol of the royal family. The reason for that is because I think the royal family has dark secrets related to the Zonai and Ganondorf. If Ganondorf is really sealed inside this location below Hyrule Castle, like we saw in the trailer, then there is no way the royal family of Hyrule isn't aware of that. I know that after the Great Calamity, almost every books and history of Hyrule were destroyed, but something like this must have been shared as a secret in the royal family. There are many theories out there regarding Breath of the Wild, but there is one in particular I didn't see anybody mention anywhere. I can be wrong, but I still want to tell you what I think about the arm we see in the trailer. The first thing that comes to my mind when I look at this scene is that the time is frozen. Ganondorf's body should actually fall on the ground simply with the gravity. I challenge you to stay up in the same position, and you will see that your center of gravity shift and don't allow you to stay up on your feet. What I see is two characters fighting each other, and time has been put in pause. How I can explain that? In this shot, that lasts less than 1 second in the trailer, it looks like it's representing a flashback or something that happened long ago. What is happening here is that Ganondorf's shadow is projected on the wall, representing himself. But for the arm, the projection on the wall looks like a full character with body and legs, who is trying to reach Ganondorf. Is this a representation of the fight that happened long ago between both of them? We now have this character with two different forms. Could this be one of the new Link power in Breath of the Wild 2? After a more closer look, what do you see here? Do not focus on the language written, but look at the overall shape. What do you see? To me, this is a dragon. If you know a little about the Zonai, then you understand that this makes a lot more sense. Take a look at the three dragons in Breath of the Wild. They have the same shape. From the top view, this shape looks like a spiral. And which race in Hyrule has a link with a dragon and also a spiral symbol? Yes, the Zonai. Do you remember the Twili in Twilight Princess? You can find a similar spiral pattern in their tribe, as well as representation of dragons on Midna's helmet and Xan's throne. Is there a link between the Zonai and the Twili? Or maybe their ancestor, the Interlopers? I don't know. Now, if you are like me, you may probably be asking yourself, if this is a dragon, where is the rest of the body? Well, I think that he played the role of an hourglass. He started to disappear gradually with time. It's like if everything has been imposed, but it's not infinite. And once he disappears completely, Ganondorf will wake up. And the moment Link and Zelda discover this place, the only thing that is left is one single arm. Dragons are the main representation for the Zonai, because this is the symbol we see the most in their culture. If I'm right, it can explain why we can have access to the maze only by using the sky. In creating a champion, according to the landscape artist Makoto Yonezu, the designs are symbolic, using dragons as courage, owls as wisdom, and boars for power. Everything regarding the Zonai is animal-themed. That's why if we see them in Breath of the Wild 2, then animals could have a much bigger impact in the game. Here are some other dragon representation you may have missed, like the animation of the letters in the sequence. They look like small dragons flying before taking the shape of a letter. Once again, they can take different forms. Or in every official representation of Link in Breath of the Wild, we can see him with this shield. And what do you see on the shield? Dragons. This is what I had for you today, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I know that you are not used to watch videos like this on my YouTube channel, but if you want to see more, just let me know in the comment section below. As always, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and check the bell icon to receive all notifications. My Patreon is also available for those who would like to support the channel and would like to see the work in progress of my next Zelda animation. I'm Erwan Link, and I will see you next time.
It's been a long time since I appeared on this channel. I've just been informed by a Gerudo that 30,000 people from across Hyrule subscribe to this channel. This is a very beautiful way to show your support. I think the next step will be 50,000, and then 100,000. What do you think? I'm very proud of the progress made over all these years, and your support is unwavering. The Zelda community is the best ever, and I'm happy to be a part of it. I see a great future ahead of us, and together, we will go very far.